Greetings, I am the cartoon hero, and welcome to part 4 of Rule Britember. God save the queen, she ain't no human being. And folks, I don't know about you, but I grew up with The Wind in the Willows. The Wind in the Willows by Kenneth Graham is a 1908 British novel that was highly successful and continues to be well remembered even to this day. Of course, I wasn't alive then, so the edition I grew up with was not the original unillustrated novel, but rather this lavishly painted yet abridged version by Don Daly. Seriously, just take a moment to look at these pictures. Is it any wonder I was captivated by this book as a child? And so captivated was I that my parents got me the movie version too. Which, it's not like there are a shortage of choices there either. The Wind in the Willows has stayed fresh in people's minds not just because of the novel, but how many times it's been adapted. It's been made into 8 different musicals, with the first one written by A.A. Milne in 1929. Yes, that A.A. Milne. And the latest one still on tour in West End. Yes, this novel is over 100 years old and it's still being performed in 2017. Wrap your head around that. And it's appeared on screen many times too, for both film and television. There's that creepy version the Nostalgia Critic talked about that one time, and you might be familiar with the Disney version, which was more focused on Toad. Also, fun fact, at one point in 2003, Guillermo del Toro approached Disney with the idea of making a live-action CG hybrid adaptation of it, but he eventually turned it down because Disney were being kinda stupid at the time. This was the era of the Disney sequels, after all. Specifically, they wanted to turn Toad into something out of Quack Pack. Yeah, I don't blame him for leaving. Pity, because I want to see his take on it. But the version I'm here to talk about is none of those. In fact, I'm pretty sure that none of you who didn't grow up in the UK at a certain time have even heard of it. The 1983 version of Wind in the Willows is a stop-motion animated movie made by Cosgrove Hall Films for Thames Television. Yes, it was a telefilm, or technically it was a pilot, because it was followed by a 52-episode TV series on ITV. Some of that covered a few short stories from the book that got left out of most adaptations, but most of it was original content. I'd check it out, but given how expensive the DVDs are, that's not very likely. And yet this pilot movie somehow made it all the way across the pond to me when I was a child, albeit on VHS. And now, I'm going to share it with you. This is The Wind in the Willows from 1983.